Hi.
Welcome to the 18th episode of Spatial Lucidity. Today I talk about worldly void. What are words if not, you know, little boxes for thought? Each word that we use to represent a feeling or to communicate obviously has a certain thought process or a feel attached to it, right from the banal to something, you know, extreme or philosophical or, you know, existential. But what I want to talk about today is how education plays an important role, not just in, you know, say in the professional sphere or, you know, the development of the masses in terms of money or lifestyle or in terms of greater opportunities, but rather on a, you know, more deep and, you know, intense level. I mean, in the sphere of thought. Education hence becomes a defining factor in how we grow personally. We all know of this experience of, you know, reading books and then being taken into a different world, or being shown an entire different range of thought, and, you know, once you finish that book, having this heavy feeling as though we have, you know, accomplished something major, but, you know, but it's very internal, something very personal. And the similar thing exists when someone is not given that opportunity, you know, this entire train of various thoughts, you know, just vanish. For example, if I never knew the word rebellion, or the concept of rebellion was never introduced to me, even though I would feel it inside, I would feel the need that I want to break away from what I find conventional, if I did not have the words in my head to formulate into a box to communicate, or at least feel in terms of, you know, verbalizing it, I would not be able to act on it. So this brings me to the point of this episode, which is how by denying education, or, you know, by putting education behind walls and barriers, we are not just stopping people from, you know, opportunity in terms of material wealth, but more importantly, an internal growth. And how I see this is that the powers that be do realize the potential of this thought process. I feel that somehow by limiting our use of words, right, like putting everything into, say, in this very blatant, by putting it, you know, range of black and white. Now I mean specifically in terms of the usage of words, the kind we see very specifically in advertising, is that we are pushing away an entire gamut of experiences, feelings, and more importantly, thought processes that would have existed, but now we have been completely denied that. And now how I see this, it's creeping into all forms of media. You see it in books, you see it in TV shows, and you see it in, you know, all other forms of expression. And somehow, you know, along the line, the whole concept of using a lot of words is somehow diminishing. We are kind of focusing on trying to make everything too simple. Like, I think it does make sense, you know, the copywriter principle of KISS, keeping it short and simple, is trickling down to everything. Is it really necessary that everything be broken down to little pieces so we can chew on it? Is it really that difficult for us to chew on something much bigger or larger? I think the last question I'd like to pose in this episode is that words are inherently important, not because of, you know, an educational perspective or, you know, trying to be very intellectual, but more importantly because they represent a certain thought. And the day we start losing our grasp on these words and where they go and what they mean and what they can probably propagate, we are slowly being turned into these 2D characters. We are thinking in 2D. The words we speak are two-dimensional, and what's really happening to us is we are turning into these caricatures that someone else has drawn of us. Thank you.